Columbia, Missouri, and Faurot Field, named for the father of the split tee, where the Missouri Tiger fans are hoping that they put together a big W. We have a ranked versus unranked battle coming up here, and you know how chaos can ensue if they start smelling an upset, as we'll see a squad from the ACC, the Boston College Eagles, taking on the 10th ranked team in the land, the Missouri Tigers. Glad to have you with us for EA Sports College Football. I'm Reese Davis, David Pollack and Jesse Palmer with me in the booth. Guys, we are ready to tee it up. Boston College about to kick it off and get this game started. Here's the return from inside his 10. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. The Tigers' offense is on the field for the first time today. And there he is, a man who makes an entire stadium hold its breath every time he touches the ball, Jesse.
This defense better have a lot of breath in this game, too, because he gets better as the game goes on. He's the kind of guy, David, who can wear a defense down.
And he is the primary focus. That's what this defense is focused and keyed in on. We got to stop him if we're going to have success today.
Solid pickup of 4 on first down. It's 2nd and 6. The lone back's got it. Into a mass of giant bodies. We'll call it a 1 yard gain to the 24.
I'll tell you, this is a running back who's very, very dangerous. And the defense did a good job getting him down there. But they got to do a great job gang tackling, because this is a guy that can break tackles and turn those types of plays into home runs.
Third down, and they'll need 5 to keep this opening drive moving. Snagged in the middle. It's Burden. He'll make a play on third down. He's got enough for the first as they mark it at the 32. Third down, a lot of times it comes down to not necessarily who's the most open, who do you trust the most?
No, it's not about the X's and the O's. It's about the Jimmies and the Joes. And when my guy's better than you and I get you matched up out wide and I know I trust you, I'm finding you.
Pulls and throws off the RPO. Didn't pick up a lot there. Moved it forward just a few.
For a wide receiver screen to work, you've got to have better blocking out front by other receivers, and they're just not physical enough at the point on that last play.
Went to the running game on first down. Now second down. To the air. It's Cook. Finds the tight end. And the defense holds firm. No pickup at all on that play.
And what a job by the defense. Seeing the quarterback throw the football, break on the football, no space allowed. As soon as he catches it, defender meet ball carrier and gets him on the ground.
If they can convert here, that type of play can really give you a shot of momentum. It's caught downfield. Good job running that route to get past the sticks, because he got nothing after the catch.
When you're a playmaker like this guy is, your coaches are going to dial up plays intended for you, especially on third down. That's what you saw in that last play. There was no question where the quarterback was going with that football. All week long, they decided on the biggest downs of this game, we're going to target our best player, and we're going to make sure that he gets looks. It doesn't matter what the coverage is, and you saw it right there on that play.
Small gain, I know, but again, the defense knows he's going to run the football. He's willing to run the football, not just drop back and pass, make him honor the run game. You got to do a lot of this.
After the productive first down play, it's 2nd and 6. The run from the shotgun. At the 35, he's loose. Defense needs to regroup as he gets it down to the 26.
Defense is going to have their hands full trying to stop this guy. They better rally to the football and get multiple hats, because he is not easy to bring down.
Missouri gets to the line quickly. They'll ride the hot hand. Got some room in under the goal line. And he's loose, and he'll take it to the house. Touchdown, Tigers.
Well, you know this offensive coordinator strips his opening 10, 15 plays, and he didn't even need that. They went 9 plays and scored a touchdown. Everything working perfectly. They looked like a well-oiled machine early in this game offensively.
Lining up for the PAT. And with the extra point, they get the first 7 of the game. So an 82-yard drive there, and it was finished off by a terrific 26-yard touchdown run. The kickoff team out there and ready to go. He'll start the return inside his 5. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. The Eagles offense has the ball for the first time. Here are our impact players for this game, and it goes beyond executing an assignment to make an impact in the game.
Yeah, obviously we were talking to both coaching staffs this week, and we asked them who needs to step up and play well. They immediately pointed to these guys right here. They are the key for their respective teams.
Yeah, and they don't always show up in the box score, but these are the guys that are the leaders. These are the guys getting everybody organized and have to play well for their team to succeed.
And the entire playbook is wide open on 2nd and short like this. Give to the running back. Brought down at the 47, but not before he ripped off 15.
Man, who says you can't run up the middle anymore, right? Everybody thinks, I got to make big plays. I got to go way out to the left, way out to the right, way out in space. Nope, right down the middle. Nice blocking. How about the running back? You could tell the speed, the wheels, does a great job getting down the field, making a huge rushing play.
Off the play fake on 1st down. And the quarterback is snowed under.
The defense just simply not fooled by the play action. Oftentimes, as an offense, you're hoping the run fake's going to slow down those pass rushers, but man, oh man, they had their ears pinned back.
The 1st down sack pushes the ball back for this long 2nd down. Looking for a gap. It's Robichaud. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Well, there's just nowhere to go for the runner on that last play. Just way too much penetration up front, and as a result, they lose yardage.
Here they come, facing 3rd and long from the 40. Looking to throw, and he needs a bunch. Finds his tight end. And he's not going to get the 1st down. Good stop there.
One of the things I love about this defense is they just have such great awareness, and they're always communicating. They understood the down and distance. They knew exactly what they needed to do to make the tackle to force the punt. That is so well done.
Boston College lining up to punt this one away. First punt of the day, and he'd love to lock them up close to their goal line. And no shot at a return here as the punt goes out of bounds. Missouri has the offense ready to go on the field. There wasn't much need to throw it around on that last drive for the touchdown, Jesse. They got it done running the ball.
And David, I don't think you have to overthink this thing. If they can't stop you running it, why would you stop handing it off? Just keep at it here on this drive.
Well, and if I'm the defense, I'm making some changes. I'm bringing in more big bodies. I'm playing more aggressive towards the line of scrimmage. I am not going to let them have that kind of drive again.
From the gun, the ground game. Solid run, picks up 6 and gets it to the 28.
Listen, I know that's not a huge game, but those run plays add up. They make you tackle the back every single play. Physically, you have to get some guy on the ground. It takes its toll throughout a 4th quarter game.
Looking for that 1st down on 3rd and short from the 28. They try to pop a run on the draw. And with that effort, they pick up a fresh set of downs. They have it at the 34-yard line.
Well, that's kind of the advantage of third and medium, right? Is the defense, you keep them guessing. You can throw it, you can run it. That time they hand it off and they pick it up.
Yeah, and you can see the D drop back a little bit. It creates a little bit of space. The running back blasts through, gets the first down.
The give from the gun. Stopped at the 44, but he got 10 on the play.
First down, you know you always want to establish the running game. How about this offense? Nothing fancy. Run the football, be physical, get a big game.
Missouri really moving on offense, set up with another first down. That's the end of the quarter, and Missouri has the lead. Guys, let's have a look at the stats as we've played one period. Now to see if these guys can get back in the game in the second quarter. Mizzou coming out with a fresh set of downs. The give to the back. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Well, the offensive line had everybody blocked except the defensive end. He was able to sneak into the backfield and get the tackle for loss.
Lost one on that last one. It's second and 11. He'll try to pop the draw. And he's able to shed one tackle and gets a pretty good pickup.
Well, the defense wasn't expecting that. They had a lot of guys back into coverage. That was second and a lot of yards to go, and they got caught off guard. Not enough guys in the box to control that running back.
Will they keep it on the ground again here on third down? Run it with the fullback. And the defense stands up this offensive line and stuffs him right at the line of scrimmage. He didn't get it. Missouri will have to send out the punt team. He ought to be able to use his first punt to pin him deep. On the move, it's Bond. Couldn't get away from that cover team, and they've got him down at the 23. BC has it back, and the Eagle offense returns to the field. Out of the gun, the give to the back. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
How about the defender being a heat-seeking missile? He was on radar lock. He found the football and flew down with some bad intentions.
Boston College wants to play fast. Dropping back, it's Castellanos. And the throw to the sideline is complete, but won't be enough for the first down.
Well, you can tell those two have been practicing the out route all offseason long. They look like they could have completed that in their sleep.
Here they come, trying to convert a third and short from the 28. From the gun, wants to pass. Snares it outside, it's Bradley.
And you know, if you're the receiver there, you just want to know where the sticks are. Maybe extend your route a little bit more so that you know you get the first down after making the catch. Fourth and short now, let's see what they do.
Boston College will send out the punt team. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. Fair catch called for and taken at the 30-yard line. Mizzou has it back in the offense coming out on the field. They'll have another opportunity to extend this lead after punting last time, David.
And it's important to put that punt behind you.
Hit the afterburners, kid! That defense got gassed, but they finally get him to the turf at the 47.
I know it's something we take for granted, guys, but the Q did a great job there with the play-action fake. He really took his time and sold it. And that's what froze the linebackers in the second level of the defense to help make that completion a whole lot easier.
Here comes the offense on first and 10 from the 47. gives it to the back on the draw. And a good, solid pickup there before the defense knocks him down.
Coaches always harp about staying ahead of the chains, and when you can run with that type of efficiency on first down, man, you are doing just that.
8-yard pickup on first down leaves them with second and short. Fires to the tight end. Gets him on the ground at the 28, but not before a big 10-yard pickup.
So difficult, because my eyes tell me as a defensive guy, he's handing it off. The offensive line's blocking run. I got to go get it. Quarterback pulls it, throws it to the right. It's kind of like that hidden hat game. Like, where's the ball? I'm always trying to find that daggone thing.
They've got it inside the 30 at the 28. First down. Complete downfield. There to make the tackle, but the big throw is good enough to give them a first down.
All right, defense, it ain't working, right? They're stringing together several first downs here. We're going to need to change this up, find something we can disrupt the quarterback and mess up this offense a little bit.
Missouri has it ready to go with another first down. From the gun, they'll give it on the inside. He pushes his way down to the floor as they get closer and closer.
Listen, you got to be able to know what play to call and what hole to go through. Like, the line blocks for a certain hole. Good job getting through the hole, getting what was blocked, getting a nice positive gain, making your situation really good on the next down.
Going to work on second down in the red zone is still some ground to cover to pick up that first down. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of 3.
There is nowhere to run and nowhere to hide on these situations. You know the physical ground game comes into play inside the 5-yard line, and they match the intensity. Nice job. Everybody flying around to the football, making the tackle for a loss. Nice job by this defense.
On third and long, he's going to have to throw for it. And he's going to be stopped just short of the first down. He tried to get it on his own.
Yeah, and the QB decided to take it himself. He got a little bit of pressure, you could see, and decided to take off, scramble, and couldn't get the first down. And now it's fourth down decision time. No matter where it is on the field or what the distance is, you know there's a chance. We still might go for it.
Here comes the field goal unit as they'll try to take the 3. Just drives it between the uprights. And now the lead is extended a little further. After putting up the field goal, they're set to kick it away. He'll bring it back from inside his 5. He was looking for more running room, but none to be found as he stopped at the 23. Boston College sending the offense back onto the field. The deficit here is just 10 points, David, so a chance to answer here.
Plenty of time left in this football game. No need to panic. This offense just has to put a couple drives together. And listen, the defense will get this back and get some stops, Palmer, and get you the football back.
And I think here too, David, you have an opportunity to keep the pressure on the opponent. Yeah, they just went down and scored, but you score here, and this game's still tight. You keep their feet to the fire, so an opportunity here to keep applying that pressure.
Lining up from the 34 on first down. Back to pass, it's Castellanos. Safe completion on the screen. They make the stop, but a good pickup there on first down.
I'll tell you what, if you want to be overzealous and you want to be a blitzer all the time, I like running the screen right behind him. Did a great job throwing the screen. Almost broke this one for a long game, but it just keeps the defense a little bit more honest if you want to start bringing a lot of pressure.
Clock's running, and they'll try to get to the line warp speed for second down. He's looking to throw. The quick out. And he gets it to the 45-yard line, and that'll be a first down. Precision, execution, and timing to pick up the first down on the out route.
I think you're spot on. Those out routes, man, it's got to be about timing. You got to throw that football before he breaks. Nice job seeing it. Short yard situation, throwing the ball on the money so the receiver can get upfield and get the first down.
wants to throw on first down. Grabbed over the middle, it's Bond. A timeout is called as this offense tries to find a way to get more points on the board before the half. It's first and 10 from the 44-yard line. Looking to move it through the air. Unloads to the wideout. Got him downfield. Slicing and dicing through this defense, and they've got it down to the 23.
Wow, the quarterback knew he had to get that one to his receiver quickly on the in route. Did you see the velocity on that throw?
This first half of offense won't go on the highlight reel so far, but starting to get things moving, it's first and 10. The short hands, it's Bond. And he's brought down after a nice game.
Hey, listen, on offense, just take what the defense gives you. Quarterback looks out wide. He sees the DB way off of the receiver. Throw him the easy hitch pass. You'll take that completion.
It's first and 10 from the 13. They're in the red zone, and they'll pass it. He's got it and still on his feet. Touchdown, Boston College! What a catch and run for six.
And I tell you what, that passing touchdown, man, that should spark this whole team. Like, the comeback is more than on now. Like, they got the touchdown. They cut into the lead. You want to get a stop and go into the half, get all the juices, all the excitement, and be like, listen, the passing game's rolling. We got this. The comeback's in full effect.
Ready to try the point after. And with the extra point, every little bit counts as they get closer. So it's a 77-yard touchdown drive, and they finish it by firing one in from the 13 for the score. So they got the touchdown, and as they kick off, really important for the defense to shut them down here. On the move from inside is five. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. Missouri has the offense ready to go on the field. Always good to get points on a drive, David, but chip shot field goals can leave you a little empty.
And I think it's great to get points, but the great teams get touchdowns in the red area. You got to get out there this time and execute a little better on this drive.
You're absolutely right, David. Generally, the best red zone offenses are the ones that run the ball the best. So let's see if they can be a little bit more physical on this drive.
One more snap coming before juice boxes and orange slices. They'll throw it on first down. Caught over the middle. It's Cooper. We've played two quarters here. Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Gentlemen, what else is new? A spirited environment there in Columbia. And I get it. A lot of coaches will say the difference between winning and losing comes down to stopping big plays and getting big plays. But if you ask me, it's more about how good you are on third down and how efficient you are in keeping drives alive. Those two stats can help you break the will of even the best defenses and help you come out on top. And with that, let's send it back to the guys at Memorial Stadium.
Missouri will put a foot to it to start us in the second half. On the run from inside his own five. And the return man is stopped, and that'll leave it up to the offense on the next drive. BC has the ball back, hoping for a party in the mods. Maybe adjustments or attitude adjustments. They've got to find a way to run the ball at least some here in the second half.
I do think you said something that's important. I think running the football is an attitude. Like, it starts with the offensive lineman and being physical, having a nasty attitude. Running back, same thing. I think they need more of that in the second half.
You know, and I think that if you're this defense, you have an opportunity to make a statement here. Yeah, I know you guys went in at halftime, you riled yourselves up, and you told yourself that you think you can run the ball on us. On this very first drive, we're going to prove to you, just like in the first 30 minutes, you cannot.
Got it. In the middle, it's Bond. And they reacted well to the completion, but it was too late to keep them from getting the first down.
I'll tell you, man, I love quarterbacks that have arm talent, but that can throw it accurately at the same time. And you saw all of it on that in route.
Boston College right back to the line. Quick handoff. Defense fills those gaps. He's got one to the 28.
Man, a lot of times you want those big plays. You want those splash plays. But sometimes you're going to take some losses. You're not going to run the football overly well. But if you continue to run, you can at least create some balance. You at least have the threat of it. Otherwise, you're just going to abandon it, and now it's just going to be a passing game.
To the air, it's Castellanos. Just a short pass to the tight end. Tackled immediately after the catch.
I'll say this, man. In college football, you see a lot of bad tackling. You didn't see it right there. That was an awesome job. First off, being there at the point of attack, once the tight end made the catch, there was no doubt he was going down. Great job, form tackle.
Passing game very effective on second down. What about here on third? Trying to make that rush think on the draw play here. Great pickup as they'll keep this drive moving, and they've got it at the 45.
And they just kind of sneaked that one in there. As a defensive guy, third and five plus, I'm thinking pass. They were thinking pass, Palmer, and they slipped the run in.
And it's so nice then to have this guy at running back too, right? Because you could throw it to him on third down or hand it off, and he's got the vision and the athleticism to go pick up that first, keep the drive going.
Grab behind the line. It's McGowan. And there is nothing doing on that one. You got the completion and nothing else to show for it.
They're trying to throw the screen out to the receiver. The defense, though, having none of that. They are just too physical. They're too fast. They force a negative play.
Lost one on that last one. It's second and 11. Got it behind the line. It's Bond. Oh, the sweet juke gets him free. He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one, and it'll be a first down.
Big play in the passing game there, and I like the receiver gearing down in the zone. Did a nice job finding the soft spot on defense between the defenders, giving the quarterback an easy target to throw to complete that throw.
The Golden Eagles have it with a first and 10. Wants to throw. It's Castellanos. And he'll chuck that one away and save the down. Nobody was able to get open.
Another incompletion, and I've said that a lot. And these teams are just struggling. I mean, the offense just doesn't know what to do. Nothing's working. Ground game, throw game. It's kind of been a rock fight on both sides.
They'll try to get on the same page this time. Second and 10 from the 31. Finds his target down the middle. And the defense had that one well covered, just a short game there.
Well, the drag routes put in this playbook to fight against man-to-man coverage. So there you see the receiver using his speed, working his way across the field. He gets separation on the DB, trying to trail him, makes the catch, turns it upfield for the first.
Third and long from the 30-yard line in this defense, hoping to knock them out of field goal range. Throws to the wideout, working the middle. A quick tackle made, but he's got plenty for the first down.
Wow, and what a great job by that quarterback finding his open receiver on third down. You know, guys, one of the most telling stats at the end of the game is third down conversion percentage. If you're a great third down team, it's invaluable to your offensive success, and that's why teams drill third down so much in practice.
From the red zone, looking for a space. He's got it on the run. Takes it all the way down to the four after making the grab, and they're set up. He's just winning that matchup in the slot every time.
And when you put him in the slot, Reese, he's closer to the quarterback. It's an easier throw. We can run in, we can run out, and really take advantage of his versatility of the guy that slot position.
First and goal now. Let's see what Boston College calls. They'll try to get it in with the run. He's got it down to the 1 yard line, right on the doorstep of Pater. Now on second and goal. trying to run it in. Touchdown, Eagles! And that one will put them up here in the second half. Well, 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 somebody's been doing their box jumps.
You ain't lying. Getting up in the air. Hey, listen, I'm taking a picture of that, saving it. That might be my screensaver on my phone, that vertical way up in the air.
On to attempt the try. And with the extra point, they're up 14-10. Precise, relentless execution on that 13-play scoring drive. And they capped it off with a one-yard plunge. Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. And he takes this from inside the five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Mizzou has it back in the offense coming out on the field. To the air on first down. And the defense makes a play, sacking him back at the 10.
And what a great way to start the second half if you're on defense. You did some really good things in that first half, and so you set the tone here early by getting a sack, and you were sending a clear message to this offense that this second half ain't gonna be easy.
If they have any intention of getting this drive going, they better come up with something on second and long from the 10. Looking to throw, it's Cook. Finds a soft spot in the middle. They bring him down, but a solid pickup to put them in position to pick up a first down.
A nice job by the QB there, timing out that drag throw. It's zone coverage, so he's got to make sure he gets it to his receiver in a window to allow him to catch the ball and then turn it upfield.
Now on third and 10, if they can move the chains here, maybe they can get this drive started. The play action fake. Looking to the big tight end. A strike downfield. They make the stop, but the sweet throwing catch is plenty to give them a first down. You know, we joke that the tight end's always open, David, but play action almost makes it impossible to keep them covered.
And yeah, because those guys, they're such good blockers most of the time. They're big and physical, and they sell block for a second, and then they run open and they find holes in zones or they get good matchups. And man, those tight ends nowadays are nightmares for defenses to try to stop.
Just willed his way for a couple out to the 35.
They're strong and they're strong. Defensive tackles, they're strong. They're such big jokers in the middle where they just lock out those offensive linemen. And running backs, listen, they don't have much of a chance. When you got that 300-plus pound guy grabbing you around the shoulder pad, you tend to go to the ground pretty quickly.
And they try the middle of this stout defense, and they rise to the challenge.
Stopping the run is about physicality. It's about I'm bigger than you. I'm stronger than you up front. Really nice job by the defense, showing their strength, bowing up, stuffing the run.
They line up with some serious work to do if they want to convert this one. On third and long, trying to have a big completion here. The sure hands, it's Burden. Really nice job there by both guys, the throw and the catch, to work that defense and get the first down. These two guys, just on the same wavelength, they make clutch connections all the time.
And that's practiced, man. That's all summer. That's all spring. Just so many hundreds and hundreds and thousands of balls where you know exactly when that guy's going to break. You know he's a stud. You're going to feed him, especially on these third down situations.
So you get stuffed on first down, and now you have the offensive coordinator thinking a little bit.
Yeah, we're probably going to have to throw it now on this second play. But what are we going to see defensively? Now that they know we're throwing, might they blitz us? Do I have to leave more guys in to block? There's a real cat and mouse game going on right now between these two coaching staffs.
And talk about spreading the ball around. Everyone getting a chance to show off the hands based on the number of targets we've seen. One more period to go to see who can make the winning plays and come home with the victory. Line getting set on second down. The give. That's what you expect from a senior. Don't give them any extra yards. Great tackle there. They're a perfect 2 for 2 on third down on this drive. They need 8 to move the chains again. Dropping back, it's Cook. Fires to the middle. He makes a catch. And they explode on that one, and they've got it down to the 22.
And I really like when offenses attack over the middle of the field. Between the linebackers and the safeties, there's usually a soft area that you can usually have some success. And really nice job by this offense taking advantage of those areas.
Looking to go up top on first down. Grabbed behind the line. It's Cooper. They make the stop right there. Good pickup and still short of the first down.
This quarterback right now is in a groove, and he's doing a nice job in pre-snap. He's reading the coverage, and he's getting an idea of where he wants to go with the football. That's why the ball's coming out of his hands so quickly, and that's why he seems like he's in a great rhythm right now.
Going to work in the red zone. They can't pick up the first down without getting it into the end zone. Leaves it with the running back. Headed to the end zone. Touchdown, Missouri! And with that, they move out front here in the fourth.
Man, I love this offense, being able to run the football late in the game when it matters and punch it in for the touchdown, and more importantly, take the lead.
Needs this one to push the lead to a field goal. And it's good, and he pushes the lead to 3. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. Here he comes from inside his own 5. And the coverage team able to wrestle him down. BC has it back, and the Eagle offense returns to the field. Now they need to put something together to answer that last score.
There's a lot of pressure, too, on this offense to have to execute at a high level. They've got to score points, David, but they can't go too fast because their defense right now is tied.
And I think that's the difficulty being a play caller. Like, I have to balance all of those things. My defense is a little bit tired. I can't put it on the field, but I got to be aggressive because this is a back-and-forth type game. So a lot to process and think about.
Boston College wants to play fast. Back to throw, it's Castellanos. Wide open downfield. And they are pushing the ball down the field. A big pickup on that one, and the tackle is finally made.
Nice play design on that one. You make it easy for your quarterback, too, because it's easy to see what's happening right in front of you. Over the middle of the field, you can see where defenders are dropping. You can see where the soft spots are in zone coverage. And just a really nice job by the QB locating his guy and making an accurate throw.
Trying to find his man on first down. Quickly out to the tight end. They make the stop, trying to pick up just a little bit at a time to get to that first down marker.
You just get the feeling this defense is going to make it hard on them, right? They've got the lead, it's late, and they're going to try to tackle everybody inbounds. Offense is going to have to really work for this and be smart. You got to attack the sidelines. You got to throw first downs. You got to keep this thing moving vertically down the field.
Back to the air one more time. Catch in the middle, it's Bond. Slammed to the ground, but not before he gets the first down.
Well, the defense did a nice job taking everything away down the field, but once the drag route was caught, they just couldn't rally to the ball carrier in time to make a tackle, and as a result, new set of downs.
BC back to work after picking up the first down. From the red zone, looking for a receiver. Makes the catch, it's Bond. He's brought down, solid pickup, but a little bit short of the first down. They've done a really good job creating the matchups they want out of the slot.
Yeah, dude, get that guy matched up on a linebacker. That guy matched up on a safety. Keep him away from the corners by putting him in the slot. Get him the football. Let him make plays.
Looking to throw on second down. Touchdown, Boston College. And they grab the advantage, taking the lead here in the fourth.
How nice is it to know, man, late in the ball game when I need it, I can keep the football on the ground, not get super complicated, pound the rock, get in the end zone, and take the lead.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point is good, and every point counts. It's now a 4-point lead in the fourth. The officials offer the deal, and the coach accepts it. They will take the penalty. The kickoff team out there to boot it away and 15 yards farther up the field after the roughing the kicker penalty. No chance for a return as that ball flies out of the back of the end zone. First down here for the offense. Quick pass on the jet motion. Finds that crease and he's got four out to the 29. They'll run this play from the pistol. Keeping it on the ground with the running back. Defense closed down quickly after a gain of three. They'll mark it at the 32. Will they keep it on the ground again here on third down? They'll try to bully their way for the first. They were all over him, nowhere to go as that third down play turned into a disaster.
Awesome job up front by this defensive line, being so good at the point of attack and eating blocks, eating some double teams that allows these linebackers to run free, unencumbered, and get to the football.
Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. On the return, it's Bond. He gets it up to the 34-yard line before he stopped, and that's where the offense will set up shop. BC has the ball back, hoping for a party in the mods. The give as they work on that clock.
Late in football games, I have a plan. I want to run the football. I want to put my quarterback in great situations if I do throw it. Low risk, keep that clock moving. Get a few first downs, and if I get a few first downs with that clock moving, I get the W and get out of here.
They'll probably bleed every second possible off this clock before they snap it. Dropping back, it's Castellanos. And that one looked great on the grease board, but when they blow it up like that, the defense is going to win every time.
How about the job and recognition by the defense? They knew exactly what they were trying to set up, and they had multiple defenders surrounding that intended target so that there was nowhere for him to go once he caught the ball.
What a big play this one could be. Tight game, getting late, third and long coming up. Looking to throw, and he needs a chunk play. He's got it. And the defense makes the immediate tackle, but he has enough for the first down.
And they did everything right in this four-minute type situation, trying to bleed the clock. First you get the completion, then you get the first down, and you stay in bounds. You could not execute that play any better.
Boston College coming to the line after moving the chains. Out of the shotgun, they go to the ground. And he finds some solid space, makes a nice gain before the defense is able to stop him. Quick timeout called by the defense, stopping the clock to save as much time as possible for their offense. Wouldn't be surprised to see them go right back to the run on second down and maybe put this thing away. He is going nowhere. Stop at the line of scrimmage. Timeout called there by the defense, desperate to get the ball back and save as much time as possible. Trying to move the sticks on third down. They'll try to move the chains on the ground. Got room at the 35. They are finding soft spots in this defense. He's got it down to the 25. Defense uses a timeout quickly, trying to get that ball back and preserve time for their offense. They'll snap it from the 25 here on first down. And the quarterback takes the snap and kneels down.